distinguished ladies and gentlemen, fellow colleagues from all UN member states, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. The unprecedented pandemic has made us realize that the world is vulnerable. Though we see a silver lining, it has given us a chance to build back better and think about how we can achieve the SDGs by 2030. The pandemic has halted development worldwide, including in Indonesia. Economic growth is projected to be minus 0.4%, poverty rate at 10.2%, and unemployment rate at 9.2%. Our 2020 annual work plan has refocused to social assistance for affected population and raising social safety net programs. We are also realigning our 2021 annual work plan to specifically address social reform and economic recovery that focused on, number one, recovery of industry, tourism, and investment. Number two, national health system reform. Number three, social protection system reform. And the last one, disaster resilience system reform. Our SDGs targets are aligned with our development planning. Despite this, Indonesia continues to mainstream SDGs national agenda to 122 SDGs targets, or 72% of the total SDGs targets are mainstreamed in our 2020 to 2024 development agenda. SDGs 1 is aligned with our planning that accentuate the poor and vulnerable, but there are challenges because of the pandemic, such as increase in undernutrition and stunted children, a competition for renewable energy as an impact of reduced fossil fuel price, and increase in unemployment, inequality, household and medical waste, and a decrease in tax revenue. We recapitulate that our efforts in implementing SDGs are ongoing in our drive to achieve our national agenda. At the sub-national level, we continue to localize SDGs, in which 25 out of 34 provinces have finalized their SDG sub-national action plan. We also continue to work with 15 world-class universities across the country as SDG centers of excellence and capacity building. We continue to uphold SDGs inclusive principle by strengthening engagement with non-state actors, including with private sector, by aligning SDGs with sustainability report. We have scaled up multi-stakeholder partnership platform where the private sector and CSO can further support government in various sectors. We also realize that the state budget is insufficient and that we need more innovative financial strategies to fill the SDGs financing gap by facilitating multi-stakeholder innovative financing for SDGs through the establishment of our SDGs financing hub. At the global level, we would like to emphasize that financing for development is a long-term and an underlying issue that is central to be the implementation of the SDGs 2030. We need to reinforce mutual collaboration and cooperation, as well as strengthen our international solidarity and multilateral approach more than ever. We must remain strong and united to achieve our common goal and continue our hard work together to ensure that the end of this pandemic could be a better, stronger, and sustainable society. Thank you.